have a baby. Right. But they
was too old. Man.
Yeah, she was too old.
Cousins right now.
Well, she thought she was too old.
Yeah.
You know what Sarah means? The word Sarah pretty much means princess in Hebrew. It means the same thing as Shar. Like Yah Sharala. That's how you say Israel in Hebrew. Yah, he is a prince of God. Yah, he, Shar, prince, Allah, God. Okay? So that proves that Sarah is royalty. You know what I'm saying?
Like, I got some stuff with my dad. My dad was in the Navy.
So
I have like a bag. I have
Israel
like
was to come out that pure bloodline.
Shit. I was already there.
You know, y'all say that Virgil, she wasn't. So she was not called Virgin Mary.
She
was already having sex.
Well, her and Joseph, she had sex at a very young age. With Joseph.
She was like a year or two before they.
Talking about Mary?
Yeah.
Yeah, Joseph had sex.
Oh, okay.
I'll get a scripture
for you.
That definition of virgin is not how America put the definition of it. What is it? Simply just a young woman? Virgins are simply young women.
Oh, this is Genesis 16 and 11.
Not necessarily, she never got fucked.
So it's pretty much a.
Yeah, because I seen that movie. She was talking well, they actually broke down the word virgin.
Oh, yeah?
Snatch. With Brad Pitt in it. He played like some Irish dude or something like that.
I know what you're talking about. That's been a minute since I've seen that movie.
Yeah, they actually had to.
He played the hell out of that guy.
Yeah, they was actually breaking it down.
Okay, he got a scripture to bring you about Abraham and Sarah.
This is Genesis 8:16-7. And the angel of the Lord found her by a fountain of water, and the woman's by the fountain in the way to Shur. And he said, Hagar, Sarai's maid, which comest thou? And where the woman not go? And she said, I flee from the face of my mistress Sarai. And the angel of the Lord said unto her, return to thy mistress and submit thyself unto her hands. And the angel of the Lord said unto her, I will multiply thy seed exceedingly, that it shall not be numbered for multitude.
I mean, Ishmael got his little blessing, because there's a whole shitload, a whole lot of Ishmaelites.
And the angel of the Lord said unto her, behold, thou art with child, and shall bear a son, and shall call his name Ishmael, because the Lord hath heard thy affliction.
And that's what Ishmael means.
Affliction. Yeah. And he will be a wild man.
And Ishmael wild as hell, ain't he? Goddamn.
Who else would put a fucking bomb on him and run into a wild man, you know?
Yeah.
And he will be a wild man, and his hands will be against every man, and every man's hands against him. And he shall dwell in the presence of all his brethren.
Them guys, Ishmael hate every goddamn buddy. They want to kill everybody. You know what I'm saying? Because they talking about they on that Allah shit. If you don't, if you don't submit to Islam, they'll chop your damn head off.
Yeah,
bro. That's some bullshit anyway.
So you don't believe that there's nothing outside our earth? There ain't no.
Hell yeah, there's something outside.
That's the terrestrial.
That's the weird thing.
That's the angels out there. The Lord said it. Hey, get that. John.
It's just us. So it's pretty much just us.
It is just us right
now. Us.
Right now.
All the trillions of miles and shit.
It's just
all
us
these,
right
there's
now.
All these different galaxies. And
it's just us.
The creation is still very young, though.
That's right. You know it's a baby. This whole everything—the sun, the stars—it's just.
It's young.
When God said, "Let there be light." What was the light?
The stars and the moon, the sun.
But the sun is. A
but
star.
Wait a minute. Oh, hold up.
But the sun is.
We
a star,
see. We all over the place.
Yeah, we is all over the place.
Yeah, but the sun.
He's
is a star, though.
Well, that's what happens. I mean, people got questions. That's what happens.
Yeah,
you know what
I
mean?
I'm just trying to understand.
Oh, your girl got up out of there. She did it. Say bye. She was with some Edomite motherfucker. That dude, she would look like a big weirdo.
He probably sent her out.
Yeah, you never know.
You know, these devils come deceitful as hell. Deceitful as fuck. By a pretty ass bitch. You know she was a demon.
Yeah, she got me a demon. But we had to teach a bitch anyway. a woman. Yeah, the people try to say that we always misogynist and we hate women. We just sat there and talked to that woman for like an hour. We didn't cuss her out of nothing.
John 14:1. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai, believe also in me. In my father's house are many mansions.
My father's house. Now, the scriptures say the temple of the Most High is not made with human hands. It said the earth is the Lord's footstool. So the father's house is the whole universe. You know what I mean? That's the father's house. He said in my father's house are many mansions, because the earth is a mansion. So you got other planets, that's a mansion. Other galaxies, solar systems.
Key, you gotta listen. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also.
So that being said, Where's heaven?
You see, there's a
heaven. This is hell.
Oh, there's multiple heavens.
Right. There's the spiritual heaven? World, the fourth dimension.
It depends on the context.
Lord and Most High is, and we're in the third dimension.
Yeah.
Okay.
Dimensions.
See, you mentioned heavens. There's dimensions.
Well, you got the different dimensions.
You said like steps of heaven.
There's many.
Look, when you read the scripture, it's all about context.
Let's make this so.
If the scripture say,
no, because.
I know.
Listen, because when you read the scriptures, it's all a different context. Like when the Lord got baptized in the River Jordan, it said a voice came out of heaven. And that means the sky.
Right.
Because when the word heaven, a lot of times when you look it up, it means sky, literally. Like this is the heavens. Like the scriptures speak about the fowls of heaven. That's a bird.
Right.
You know what I mean? But then you got another heaven, which is the heaven above the heavens, which is outer space. And then you got the spiritual world, heaven, okay? And then you got the kingdom of heaven, which we know that's not in the sky or in the outer space. Okay. That's going to be right here on earth. That's the kingdom of heaven.
So it's going to be a whole new earth
established.
This whole earth is going to be reshaped, period.
Yeah.
It's going to actually grow a little, you know?
Right.
A little. It's going to grow a lot. It's going to multiply, you know, just like now. You know, everything's a smoke.
Because even the earth itself is heaven, it was supposed to be. Because really the earth originally was a paradise. Before all this concrete and pollution and all this shit, this was a paradise.
So what's the afterlife to y'all?
That's the spirit world.
Spirit world.
You go, everybody dies, we all go back to the Father.
Everybody. Our spirits
go back to the Father. And then until... Scripture say we rest. We go get some rest and then he bring you back.
I was told that if you once you die, you and Abraham's arms or some kind. Before Jesus was crucified, it was said that when he was crucified,
Abraham's
bosom took the key from Satan.
No.
Took the key of death from Satan himself or whatever. Yeah. And then that's when God starts.
I know what you give reference to, but they twisting that on people.
Yeah, they do.
So everybody was just in some middle room.
He ain't go take no key from Satan. Like
that's talk. That's
give me your car keys.
That's mixing two things together.
Don't that say that in the scripture? Though?
That's talking about two.
That's not what it's
they mixing
about.
Two different things.
It's a parable.
That
right.
That was in the book of Revelation. When you read Revelation, every time it talks in the book of Revelation, I'm only talking about Revelation. In Revelation, every time it says Satan and the devil, it's specifically talking about the Roman Empire in America.
Let me check this out. Let me read this. This is a second
Ezra. Hold up. That's why it said the devil shall cast you into prison. He read that earlier in Revelation. Revelation.
Right.
Because who's the devil? Who cast you into prison? The devil. Okay? That's that. The United States, the government, the police. You know what I mean? That's the Romans. The Edomites. Esau.
2:2-13 it says, go, and ye shall receive. Pray for a few days unto you, that they may be shortened, that the kingdom is already prepared for you. Watch. Them angels been going back and forth. I mean, you know what? There's a couple of videos that NASA had those cameras just pointed out to Infinity, just pointed out.
What's up?
And they seen, I mean,
you gotta get out, come up here.
Shitload. I mean, thousands of UFOs come out of light speed and slowed down. Like they were coming from somewhere doing their work, doing a job, you know what I'm saying? Some of them were still going fast as hell. You can see them.
Highway or
I gotta, man, that's a bad, we used to look at the video a lot. That's a badass video anyway. All those planets right now, just like the animals were here before us, man, right now those planets is already prepared. They already got giant trees and, man, like I said, the kingdom is already ready. So the planets are part of the kingdom? Yeah, it's going to be part of our inheritance.
Well, we're going to have...
I thought supposed to represent symbolism.
No,
it's supposed to be... I thought the scripture says, supposed to mean Satan.
Listen, the scripture says... That's Esau.
Yeah, that's just what...
Esau.
Yeah, that's a heathen to take a planet and start worshiping it, make up his own story.
Jeremiah 10 that he was reading. Be not dismayed at the signs of heaven, because the heathen are dismayed at them.
Because back in the ancient world, they looked up at the sky, and they noticed there were certain stars that moved faster than the other star, and they moved in an irregular pattern. Those are the planets. So since they saw because the planets look like a star. You know you can see Jupiter at nighttime, right? It's one of the biggest stars in the sky. Yeah, it is the biggest. It's huge. So they seen that big-ass star, and they seen it moving on its own fast as shit across the sky. And they're like, oh, that's the God.
They just use their imagination.
And then they see Mercury. Mercury moved faster than all the planets.
Wait, Mercury moved?
Yeah, it's a planet.
I think that's the closest one to the sun.
Yeah, yep. But you'll see Mercury in the sky. It moves faster than all the other planets. So that's where you get Hermes, and he's got he's fast as shit. That's where the Flash come from. The Flash is, you know, the superhero. Yeah. It's based on the Greek god Hermes or Mercury. He got the wings on his head and all that. Right, you know what I mean?
So we know those planets are part of our inheritance. So when we're back, when we establish the kingdom and put this devil in slavery on Earth, we're going to be taking slaves to those other planets.
But those are all fucked up ass planets.
No, that's Esau's thinking. That's his,
one is made
that's, his, that's his wisdom he got out there.
They ain't
thinking
they ain't never
that Mars is uninhabitable. There's old pyramids with a face of a man on Mars.
Yeah, they don't know that. They don't know
that. No, that's been something that's been
they ain't even
painted
been,
on.
They haven't even nothing.
Been to what you call the moon. Right. Never even been to the moon.
Hell no.
Bullshit.
Yeah, that's bullshit, exactly.
What?
They can't make it to the moon.
There's many documentaries about that.
Yeah, get on YouTube and talk about moon landing hoax.
They even got pictures where you could point out where it can't be on the moon. Because the flag... Actually, the regular moon picture you see all the time, they use on TV, the flags waving.
Yep. And then the dust that the
thing landed,
the rover's kicking up is the same.
Yep, no crater.
The dust is the same, has the same gravitational effect on the dust as it does on the Earth. I mean, it's like a billion different ways you can prove it.
Because that thing had no crater at the bottom of it. That shuttle that landed in that so-called spot, there should have been that's a big-ass rocket. It should have been some type of crater or something, but it's just a flat surface.
Down,
yeah, when it came down, yeah, but it's a flat surface.
Man, only proof you need, bro, is just look at the shit that they said they went to the moon with. It looked like it was made out of aluminum
foil.
It looked like it looked like something out of a sci-fi movie from the 50s, bro.
It did.
It looked cheap as hell. I seen better looking spaceships in a movie.
Yeah, that shit,
Oh, hell no.
But they say Stan, you know who Stanley Kubrick is? No. He's a director. He made his movie called 2001 Space Odyssey. You heard of that?
Yeah, I heard of that.
And that came out the same year as the moon landing. And then that movie's all about space. It has some of the best special effects you've ever seen, especially for back in the 60s. 1969? But they said Stanley Cooper, he had them directing skills, you know, special effects skills, so they hired him to fake the moon landing. And actually, the movie looked more real than the moon landing. Yeah. Goddamn Star Wars looked more real than that shit. You know what I mean?
It does. They're clever as hell. The devil's clever.
The world crazy
as fuck. Yeah, remember we had that, there was a Red Hot Chili Pepper song, and they were singing in that song about, what did they say? The final frontier was made in a Hollywood basement or some shit like that.
Space may be our final frontier, but it's made in a Hollywood basement.
Exactly. It's all fake.
Here you go.
Because they part...
Everybody just living around a bunch of lies.
Great delusion.
The Earth is given into the hands of the wicked.
Come on, because who owns all the news stations? All the news we're fed to from a fucking so-called Jew. The devil himself.
That's right. You know Jeremiah, man? 31:35.
Oh, hold up. They said, I was listening to Alex Jones, and he said, you know about that Bohemian Grove shit?
Yeah.
When they was sacrificing child to the giant idol?
Uh-huh.
He said the high priest was Walter Cronkite. And Walter Cronkite was one of the top news guys. You know what I'm saying? From back in the old school. He was, I forget what news station he was on. As before my time, but he was like one of the most famous news anchors in the history.
Didn't Dan Rathers take over for him?
I don't know. Maybe.
What the fuck wrong with this damn place?
But yeah, so he was a high priest of Baal, pretty much. And he's a motherfucker giving you your news.
Ain't Baal, it's like Satan.
So you know he all discombobulating the news.
Baal, the devil, he got all kind of names.
Okay, Jeremiah 31 and 35. Thus said the Lord, which giveth the sun for a light by day, and the ordinance of the moon and of the stars by a light by night, which divideth the sea when the waves thereof roar, the Lord of hosts is his name. If those ordinances, listen, if those ordinances depart from me, said the Lord, then the seed of Israel also shall cease from being a nation before me forever. Thus said the Lord, if heaven above can be measured, and the foundation of the earth searched out beneath, I will also cast off all the seed of Israel for all that they have done, saith the Lord. Now, you see these people still here? Now, the devil, I mean, always claiming it done, went to the bottom of the sea. They claiming they ain't sent little submarines to the bottom of the sea. But they ain't going nowhere, man. To a fool, they accept that. And they even got the stars mapped. They even say they got drones on Mars still roaming around for years.
And they can't decide if it's going to plan it or not.
You know what I mean? What about the Orion's Belt thing?
Orion's in the Bible. You know what Orion is called in the Bible? When you read the King James, it's in the book of Job. It says Orion, but when you look it up in the Hebrew, it says Kasal, which means the fool. Orion's a goddamn fool. Look it up, bro.
What?
It's the Hebrew word for Orion is fool. There's only a fool would worship some Orion. Only a fool would line up some pyramids to Orion.
Only a fool.
Yeah, because you know, there's little stuff like that in the Bible. It talks about the Pleiades.
I thought I had a picture of it, but I guess I don't. I'm just going to download it.
No, I mean, could you use the stars to navigate? You know, like during slave times, they used the North Star to know how to get north, or so they say. That's probably some made up shit. I don't know. But Harry Tubman, that fucking bitch. I mean, because you can talk so many lies.
Fuck that black bitch.
Yeah, fuck that bitch.
Fuck that black bitch. That bitch went number
one. She's an Israelite.
She was.
She's an Israelite.
Oh, yeah, you're right. You're right about that.
She was doing.
She, that's where you're wrong.
She was leading them up here. Yes.
Yes. She's a sellout black piece of shit.
That's why, come on, bro. Anybody your school,
no, I'm serious.
Anybody your public school tells you is somebody to idolize, think the opposite. When you go to school, they tell you Harry Tubman, the greatest person ever. They tell you to worship Lincoln. Lincoln was a big weirdo and a devil worshiper. He is responsible for damn near a million people getting murdered.
Martin Luther King,
he's a homosexual, part of the Boule. They tell you to worship fraternity.
That's a Greek fraternity.
Was it only, though. Was it Sigma?
A nigga only club.
It is Sigma 55.
Mm-hmm. Nigga only club.
Yeah.
Why you know he was doing
Sigma? Nigga faggot club.
They got the... Just Google that shit, man.
That's what they are, a bunch of faggots. Anyway. This is more proof they didn't go to the moon.
Okay.
Because the Earth is surrounded by what you call a van-out radiation belt. How they go through that? If they can't even make a fucking suit to go into the...
Yeah, they even got clips. They even got clips on them damn devils actually trying to do that.
Mm-hmm.
And they get some type of cancer.
They start getting sick, vomiting,
yeah,
sleep.
Lose their hair, get real bad scars,
so
got radio.
They can't even pass this shit.
They can't even pass it.
And that's way out there too.
Yeah, I've seen that.
Because you can go up for miles and miles.
Like 30 miles.
That's a lot.
It looks like a chemical burn on their body.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, right.
They lose their hair and every fucking thing.
And another thing, because the angels.
They vaporize the ship.
But so let's pretend they got past it. The angels will fuck them up as soon as they got out there. No, don't you? Look, the Russian cosmonauts was out there, way out there, you know, as far as they could go. And there's a Russian cosmonaut who said that he seen a celestial being, an angel. He said it was giant. He said it was giant. It had wings and had the face of a human. Mm. And it came up, bugged them out, looking in their windows, looking at them.
Huh?
Yeah.
They're frightened, their face. They're frightened.
And he said it was giant with the face of a human. They said it was celestial. Because they had to be able to survive.
Hey, Deshaun, can you hold this?
To be able to survive out there,
back's getting sore.
We can't have flesh.
You gotta have a celestial body.
That's right.
Because like we can't even be able to go to the, we can't travel to another galaxy in a human body. You'll die. You gotta have a celestial body to survive out there.
That's why.
That's why we're called terrestrial beings. We were. That's why we're called Adam. Adam. Adam comes from the word the ground. The Lord designed these bodies we in to be on the earth, not out there.
And that's what terra means.
The earth. That's what Adam means.
That's what we're made of.
Yeah, we're made of the
water.
Yeah, the dirt. Right, so we're not even made to survive out there. Damn. You'll fucking shrivel up and die. You get burned up.
That makes sense.
Plus, they even tell you...
I got it right here. Oh,
go ahead.
This is 1 Corinthians 15 and 38. I can't hear.
What the fuck?
Just molested a little child.
Maybe he probably did. He about to shit himself. He's running for the bathroom.
He just. Okay, so 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians 35. No, I'm sorry, 15. 1 Corinthians 15 and 38. Whew. But the Most High giveth it a body as it hath pleased him, and to every seed his own body. All flesh is not the same flesh.
See, all flesh is not the same.
But there is one kind of flesh of men, another flesh of beasts.
Like bird, we can't fly like the birds, okay? And like a tiger got different flesh than us, they got superpowers. A tiger is pretty much a superpower creature. We ain't got that kind of power. We can. A tiger can jump damn 10 feet high, take your head off with one swipe. Mm.
Another flesh of beast, another of fish, and another of birds.
Yeah, fish can breathe underwater.
Shit, them fishes be outrunning them speedboats.
Yep.
You know, especially those swordfish, they're some fast-ass fish, man. Watch it, look at videos of barracudas, look how they move.
Yep.
They should've bug you out, man.
So verse 40.
Look how dolphins move.
Oh yeah, dolphins are bad as fuck.
Mm-hmm. Nothing. The body ain't nothing but pure muscle. The whole entire body of these fish.
A dolphin can they use them to fight sharks.
Mm-hmm.
They fight. They beat the
shit
out.
They fucking them up too.
They fuck the shark up.
Yep. Yep. And sharks, they think they are intelligent.
Shark is scared of a dolphin.
Yep. Oh, there's all kind of videos of great of killer whales destroying giant. Great white sharks.
Yeah, because the sharks are kind of dumb, man.
You see the one shit with the killer whales was trying to get this seal.
Mm-hmm.
They couldn't get to it, so they started rocking the ice.
Yeah, they all in tandem lined up and swim.
Yeah,
and made the iceberg.
Yep, so it could fall off.
That's some awesome shit, man.
Yeah, they're smart. They got intelligence.
Yeah.
There are also celestial bodies and bodies terrestrial.
Okay, which one are you?
40.
I know, but which one are you in there? There are also celestial bodies and also terrestrial. There you go.
The angel is celestial.
Okay, why would he mention... Mm-hmm. I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
Why would he mention celestial if it didn't exist? You know what I'm saying?
You're right.
Now, we're reading the Bible here.
That's why when you read the book of Daniel, the angel appeared before Daniel, and he was glowing, power emanating. Daniel
Dragon Ball Z?
Daniel.
Yeah, like a Super Saiyan.
Super Saiyan.
Yeah,
y'all see the new one?
Kai?
What?
The Super Saiyan, Dragon Ball Z, the Battle of the Gods.
Oh, that just came out.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, my sons, man, they love that Dragon Ball shit.
It's pretty bad.
That's all they talk to me about. I don't know what the hell they talking about. I just know that, who's that big fat bastard?
I'm sorry, these little kids are way beyond this, man.
Oh, yeah.
They're way beyond, you know?
Oh, look.
You talking about, like, worldly type?
No, I mean, like he, they got, for example, this is their dad. This man searches wisdom out. Now, he gives it to his boys. Right. Now, they ain't nothing but, what, eights?
Yeah, what, oldest was 9 and 7?
Now, imagine them when they become our age.
Mm. My son, be telling me about, he be looking shit up. He's into ancient battles and war. He be talking about cavalry unit. He be playing the strategy video game.
Oh, I love it.
He's on to the, what's that, the Age of Empires and all that.
Ooh, that's my favorite.
Yeah.
Empires, all types of total war games.
And you guys, that's really some scholarly. That's a scholarly video game. That teaches you some shit.
Yeah, man, imagine if you guide your kid to be nothing but into football, football.
Playing Madden.
You should be a master of it. You know what I'm saying? Especially when you start him as a kid.
You got dad's doing.
You know, which is a waste of time now. It was a time for that, but now it ain't. Now is the time to keep your kids some wisdom.
Getting ready
for the times.
It hasn't been the time forever, though, since, though. For real. Really hasn't been time for none of this shit.
Well, we in the information age now.
What do you mean by that?
We got the internet. I can Google anything I need to know. Well, pretty much.
Woo!
Man, you can even Google who are the real Israelites.
What comes up?
Yep. You'll get some.
It's over millions of those.
You get some interesting information.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I mean, you can't trust everything you read on the internet. You gotta filter everything through the scripture.
That's why you gotta have a solid foundation. Then you can go searching out wherever else. You know what I'm saying? Then you can read a book of the dead and not get bugged out.
Cause there's a lot of bugged out shit out there. Like that's the stuff you was bringing out earlier about some people believe that those fake Jews in Israel are actually Canaanites and Hittites.
Yeah.
But we know when you read the scriptures, it tell you that they're Edomites, but Esau married a Hittite. You know what I'm saying?
That's right, that's right. Daniel 12:4. But thou, O Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book even to the time of the end. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall be increased.
Yeah, we in that
age of information.
The age of information. The information highway. What do they call it? The
information highway.
Whatever they call that shit. The super highway.
That's what it is, though. Watching Betty Sue fuck a donkey.
Yeah, you know,
there's people that sit in front of the computer all day long that go see shrinks and psychiatrists because they can't stop watching a bitch stick eels up in her pussy. or him stick eels up in his ass. You know what I mean? That's a straight even right too. You know me though, because there's a difference. People, the two-thirds ain't looking for wisdom. They ain't using the internet for wisdom.
They use it for world star hip hop.
That's the two-thirds going down. What happens to the rest of them?
What do you mean? One-third going to get delivered. They're going to be a great destruction company.
Oh, I got a script.
You ever seen the movie Left Behind?
Yeah, I mean, I know
there's a new movie. One coming out.
Yeah, heard that movie.
I seen the Kirk Cameron one. That big faggot.
Nicolas Cage making a new one.
Oh yeah, that's gonna be good.
Yeah, Nicolas Cage making some.
Yeah, what you getting though?
But you know, a lot of people.
We was talking about how we can raise the kids up.
Oh, okay.
See, a lot of people think those Left Behinds is. No, people will read Left Behind books before they read the Bible. But we got people come up all the time, and they quote that shit like that scripture. You know what I mean?
They do though. Hey, that's funny shit.
They do bring that shit up.
Baby's mama, she had the whole damn collection. I was like, why don't you just read the Bible?
Here you go.
She read a stack of books since then.
Let me get this scripture real quick. This is Proverbs 22:6. Train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it.
Right. That's a straight to the point scripture.
Hey,
read that again, man.
Thank you right there.
He was trying to get eye contact with me too.
Oh man. Proverbs 22:6.
I love you.
Train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it.
Right. So yeah, we supposed to be raising our children up on this truth. That's why they said no Bibles in school.
Well, I used to be in the military.
Yeah, I was until, I think,
Bush came in, the first Bush came in and took them away.
What?
The Bibles. The Bibles used to be in the military.
Oh, I think
they used to hand out Bibles in the military.
Oh, yeah. Well,
Ronald Reagan.
They just recently did that. That was under Obama. When they said it,
you ain't allowed to have them.
That was just recently, last year, I think, under Obama.
Yeah, but back in the day, they used to, the military hands them out.
Well, every platoon has their own chaplain.
Okay.
Or every platoon or every division. I can't remember. I was in the Marines.
Yeah.
And we always had the chaplain. And every Sunday or whatever, they actually, when I was in boot camp, they made you go to church.
What?
You had no choice.
We watched the little old World War II movie. They, even though it was a fake preacher, but they at least had a preacher or something. If he was on your deathbed, at least have a preacher or something come in.
Yep.
But they probably won't have that no
I heard they was on the battlefield too, like not in the battlefield.
Yeah, on the battlefield too, yeah.
Yeah, they're in the battlefield.
Yeah. They in the battlefield?
They got a chaplain, yeah.
Oh, wow, I didn't know that.
And the chaplain, some of them won't carry pistols, but a lot of them do. They're like, I ain't going out there without no pistol.
Okay, check this out. We're talking about the one third and the two thirds.
Yeah.
Separation. This is a first Thessalonians 4:15.
But the rapture's gonna happen before that happens.
Well, the rapture. See that rapture thing?
Rapture.
They got a lot of
what? They're in the scripture.
Well, the word rapture means the same thing as rape. It means to take. Well, it does.
Take hold.
It means to take hold and take you away. So there is going to be a rapture, but not the way these churches teach it. You know what I'm saying?
I always say the rapture always already happened. When Esau came over here and slaughtered.
Oh, that was a rapture for your ass.
You know what I'm saying?
But the Lord is going to come. Like that's in Revelation 18. When the Lord said that you hear a voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people. And that's when the Lord going to beam us up. He's going to take us up into those chariots, and like the song says, swing low, sweet chariot, come with it, take me home.
You know what? I'm gonna put it down in Hebrew. I'm gonna repeat that every day. Come out of her, people.
Oh, yeah.
Just repeat it every day, man.
Come out of her, my people.
Just repeat it every day. Here you go. This is 1 Thessalonians 4:15. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout.
Yeah, from the heavens, that's the sky.
With the voice of the archangels.
The archangels.
And with the trump of the Most High Yahweh.
Where the Lord said the angels are the reapers. And they're going to come down. There's a harvest. We're the wheat.
That harvest.
The angels are going to separate the wheat from the tares. They're going to harvest the wheat and they're going to burn the tares up in a fire.
Beautiful. And with the trump of Yahweh, and the dead and the anointed shall rise first. Listen, then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds.
In the clouds.
To meet the Lord in the air.
There's your UFOs.
In the air.
It ain't no aliens. Okay.
Right,
you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, you got some.
You ain't talking about flying saucers. And
that's
shit,
right.
The flying saucers.
Flying
are the saucers.
That's
come on,
right.
Man.
But the flying saucers.
You talking about the lights?
They gonna come in many different sizes.
That comes straight out of Ezekiel.
They gonna come out of many. They gonna be many different.
Wait, so you believe that?
It was a
flying saucers.
They actually. They have some of them look like flying saucers.
Discovery Channel.
Some of them
ain't nothing
around.
Ain't nothing looking like no raggedy shit Esau flying around in.
Hell no.
You know what I'm saying? This is a new video of a UFO car show.
You know those flying saucers are like machinery type shit.
No.
Esau do have his version of these UFOs.
Yeah.
That they gonna bring out. Okay?
They got their they gonna try to fight the angels with them.
Right. But the UFOs.
Is that what they talking about in Revelation?
That's
when they say that
we've been.
That's what they talking about in Revelation when they said that Satan's gonna bring his army.
Angels.
Yeah.
To fight. Pretty much talking about fighting the UFOs.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
That's what, why they was coming out with those alien invasion movies to make you think
like
some fucking aliens and shit.
Yeah, like what's that? Independence.
I thought it was
Independence
supposed to be
Day,
like spiritual.
No.
Like a little spiritual thing, like a spiritual fight type shit.
The
angels and demons coming
tell
at
you,
each other.
I tell you, well, those demons is the airplanes. They even call the airplanes the angels, like the blue angels.
Mm-hmm.
You know the ones that fly in the stunt formations?
Yeah.
The air shows, they call them angels. Those Satan's angels.
shrooms.
They got wings too, just like angels have wings.
There's a lot of shit that sends like subliminal messages and stuff.
Well, I mean, everything.
Well, that's why we out here to teach you what's what and what's what.
Right.
That's that Bible code.
Right. Yeah.
That you can open up Revelation all you want, but you're not going to be able to interpret none of it. You know what I'm saying?
We here misinterpret it for a lot of different things.
If you ain't Revelation, you better leave it alone. Revelation, Daniel, leave it alone. If you don't even read history, leave it alone.
Like I said, every time you see Satan in Revelation,
you can't even get into the scriptures without going into history.
There you go.
Right, because Revelation was written by John while he was in prison on the Isle of Patmos. The Romans threw his ass in prison, so every time he talked about the Romans, he called him Satan. He couldn't just say the Romans or the devil. They would have ripped his letter up. You know what I mean?
That's right.
They would have ripped that shit up. So it's all on code.
There you go. This is Revelation 12:7. And there was war in heaven. Michael and his angels fought against the dragon.
That's the Romans, which today is called America, the American Empire, which is Rome. It's the same shit.
And the dragon fought and his angels.
Yep, because an angel basically means messenger. That's your sidekicks. That's your henchmen. Okay, because Michael, that's pretty much like the general, the Most High's army. Well, right under Yahweh Shai, you know what I mean? Because the order in the heavens goes Yahweh Shai, well, the Most High, Yahweh Shai, and under him is Michael. Michael's the head angel. That's why he's called the archangel.
That's right. I thought Michael was Jesus so far.
Nah. Michael is the archangel. Arch means leader.
Why I don't go to church?
Oh, that teach that?
Yeah. Bug you out.
I never heard that.
Damn.
Yo, hold
up. This is why I don't go to church.
I've heard that plenty of times. I heard that growing up.
Oh, they said Jesus is
Michael.
Michael.
Yes. Yep. My grandma said that.
That's all I heard him.
That too. Mother tell her.
Let me finish reading this.
Yahweh Shai is the angel of death. That spoken of in Exodus.
That's right. And the dragon fought and his angels and prevailed not.
Prevailed not. Just like in that movie Independence Day when they fought the chariot, the giant spaceships.
That's some shit.
But they try to pretend like the like Will Smith and Randy Quaid defeated the angels.
Right.
The Battle of Los Angeles.
Oh, that
Lost
too.
Lost Angeles.
Yeah, he ended up beating them with some bullshit too,
gave
didn't he?
Gave the mothership a virus.
I think.
Gave the mothership a boat. Mothership a boat.
It's really supposed to mess up for a Los Angeles.
Yeah, the city of Angels.
Missouri.
They gave the mothership a boat.
Right. That's some shit, man. This devil crazy, man. That's why devil means deceiver.
I was mad as hell watching Battle of Los Angeles.
Yeah,
I was like, man, this is some bullshit. Your boy is pulling some John Wayne shit.
Yeah, I was very disappointed. I thought there was going to be a badass movie.
And a lot of these movies have that theme. I was watching one of those Avengers cartoons, and the Avengers was the same thing. The aliens came down, the Avengers defeated the aliens.
Mm-hmm.
And they always show how the government has got their special forces defeating the aliens.
Damn, so pretty much that's the subliminal message entitled to pretty much God's angels.
They keep, that subliminal message of when those chariots coming out of the sky is the enemy.
Ah, yeah.
So when everybody see them, they're gonna start shooting at them. Yeah. Not knowing it's the Lord.
So pretty much the motherfuckers know that's gonna
actually,
be
actually, didn't one of the presidents say
nah,
that?
These bastards ain't gonna know shit.
Invasion.
No, I'm talking about the government.
Oh, they already did. They're working against it right now.
They know.
Yeah, they've been preparing against it.
Right.
They've been preparing against it.
And that go back to the so-called Jew who makes all those movies.
Right.
Because he's he wants people to help him. He's like, I'm afraid of these ships. We gonna have to fight them because they could come back and put me in slavery.
Two thirds is gonna help.
You know, that's why the part of Israel motherfuckers know that shit too.
Who makes up the military force?
Israel.
Who has a military force?
100.
As a matter of fact, who makes up most of the military force on the planet Earth?
Israel.
That's Israel. There's a lot of heathens in those armies, like all of them.
When I was in the Marines, it wasn't nothing but Mexicans. Half my platoon was damn Mexicans.
Damn.
It was Mexicans, so-called black people.
Mm-hmm.
And if there's any white people, it was, Irish, Scottish, German.
But, Deshaun, what you talking about?
There wasn't no Jews.
What? You said 100 people. You said it was going to be 100.
That's it. Now, you talking about 44,000 thing?
That's
it. Nothing but no 100.
Oh.
No, you talking about
100 people was going to slaughter, like.
No, I said
44,000?
You talking about, 100 people will send 10,000 in flight?
souls.
Yeah,
that's talking about that. Yeah, that's that spiritual power. That's just
bad scripture.
What that's saying is, the Lord gonna give us power, just like used by the reading Thessalonians that we'll be changed. Mm-hmm. He gonna give us that power. We're gonna be like King David used to be. Because you read the scriptures, it said King David killed tens of thousands.
That's that.
Oh yeah, Corinthians, yeah.
So pretty much, we were both. God's gonna get a power to strengthen his people to do some Dynasty Warriors type shit.
Right, right. Let me finish reading. Or now Hyrule Warriors.
Hyrule Warriors, yeah.
It prevailed not, neither was their place found anymore in heaven. And the great dragon was cast out. That old serpent called the devil.
The old serpent.
And Satan, which deceiveth the whole world, he was cast out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him.
Five more years of this settlement book is going to make this
situation. Yeah, so they ain't going to be no more Esau patrolling the sky.
So y'all don't believe Barack Obama is like...
God damn faggot.
I know he is. He's not the Antichrist?
No, he's a Antichrist.
Yeah,
he was mentioned in the Bible though.
But
in the Hebrew it said, I saw lightning come down.
Okay.
And then in the Hebrew it says,
But it actually don't say
come
that.
Come on, man. It's a lot of subliminal messages in movies.
But it actually don't even say that, because that book that was written was not written in Hebrew. It was written in Greek originally. It was written by Paul, and Paul wrote all those books in Greek.
But you don't believe those speeches that Barack Obama said, saying, be still, you know that I am God, I will be exalted upon the nations, I will be exalted upon the earth.
But
you don't believe
that's the subliminal message
of him saying that?
That could be.
You see what I'm saying?
Man, they people
and
might...
You don't believe the Pope is the false prophet? Is the possibility of a false prophet? I'm talking about that was mentioned in the book of Revelation, the scripture.
Man, they've been saying every Pope for the past 500 years was Antichrist.
But this is that. But we in the end times, though. This, like y'all said, this is the cream of the crop right here.
But there's nowhere in the Bible that specifically states that there's this one dude called the Antichrist that was going to appear. It don't never say that.
It's a legion of those fuckers.
A legion of those fuckers.
Of course it's a legion, but it's the ones, though, that control a lot of shit, though, that has the power to control
a lot
of shit.
They might make somebody out to be...
So, but why would Congress make Barack Obama the...
They set Barack Obama up as a messianic figure. Yeah, they did do that.
This is what I'm trying to get at. So why would he... So you don't believe that he'll be the last president that America will ever have?
It might be.
I don't know.
I hope so.
I hope so, too.
I hope so.
You know what I'm saying?
Because they said the same thing about George Bush, though. They said he's the last president.
He even in his little speech thing, he even said that he had a little thing that he wanted to give that he came from or whatever. And he had that Lion King show.
Yeah,
he pretty much called himself the king. You know what I'm saying? The Lion King.
George Bush's initial GWW is the number 6. Okay, so people say he was the Antichrist because his name represented 666. Mm-hmm. And then they said
Reagan, because Ronald Wilson Reagan is 666.
That's 666 too.
They've been bugged out about this shit for a long time.
Yeah, so. No, that's just.
Don't believe that Barack Obama played a big part in the Bible?
Of course he didn't. He's not in the Bible per se. But let me read this. This is 1 John. This is 1 John 2 and 18. Little children, it is the last time. And as ye have heard that Antichrist shall come, even now are there many Antichrists, whereby we know that it is the last time.
So they've been,
there are many.
They've been people being called an Antichrist for thousands of years.
So what? So in the book of Revelation, when he talks about the Antichrist,
it don't never say that in Revelation. It says the false
Revelations
prophet.
Or it says the prophet or whatever.
They try to use the scripture in Revelation that says the false prophet.
Because the false prophets try to make a one world.
But there's many false religion. Prophets.
And then
just like in the book of Matthew, it said many shall come in my name saying I'm Christ, or lo, here is Christ. Let's get that. There's many people to do that, man. There's always somebody claiming to be the Messiah. You know what I mean? They've been doing that for.
But he did a lot of things the Antichrist would do, though.
He is an Antichrist.
No. I'm talking about as the scriptures proclaim.
Okay,
so rolled into Israel.
Okay,
so who else rolled into Israel?
Okay, but listen. That's just an act they've been playing out.
Yeah.
That's playing out.
Yeah.
because he knows the future.
He thinks he's God, though.
He's been guided like a puppet.
Everybody,
and the people that guide him know the scriptures. The people behind the scene that guide him, that Jew.
Because he's not even the real leader, the Rothschild.
Right. But listen, David Cameron on here over there, what is he then?
Yeah, he's the Antichrist.
What is he then? You know? Because he's a Barack Obama over there.
What about the Queen of England? She said she's of the tribe of, she claims to be from the tribe of Judah.
What the fuck? That's right.
No, don't you know that?
What? The Queen of England.
To rightfully be the King and Queen of England, you gotta descend from the tribe of Judah. So they lie and they say they're Israelites. You didn't know that?
No.
They stole to be the King of England, you gotta be from the tribe of Judah.
Say you swear, bro.
No, I ain't swear on nothing.
You swear, you can't.
Bible says,
swear, bro.
Well, I know.
Google that shit.
Are you for real though?
You got to be from the tribe of Judah to be the King of England. Or falsely claim that you are. That's why the Bible said the scepter shall not depart from Judah.
I got it.
Oh, go ahead.
This is Matthew 24:5. For many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ.
Let's read that again.
Deceive many. This is Matthew 24:5. For
many
shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many.
Like, you even got this dude down in Australia right now. I can't think of his name. This dude in Australia, he claims that he's Jesus, and his wife is Mary Magdalene. And he got a whole, we got people, this dude came.
But that's crazy people though.
No, but
you're gonna see a lot of motherfuckers.
Exactly, a lot of motherfuckers doing that shit.
But what I'm talking about though, I see what you're saying, but I'm talking about, we at the end times, bro.
Okay.
You're bugging yourself out.
You're thinking too deep. You're trying to be too deep.
All right.
You're trying to be too deep.
I mean, it sounds good, though. It sounds good.
But that's.
Yeah, I mean, he is the devil.
You need them people starting to push that bullshit to you, man. Barack Obama is an Antichrist. He is the Antichrist.
And they did,
but he's not so supreme Antichrist.
Even like Louis Farrakhan called him the chosen one.
The chosen one, the fuck is.
You know what I'm saying? But now Louis Farrakhan called him. Now he's pretty against much. Him. Now he's against him.
You know, just like all the Democrats are getting turned against him now.
Yep.
They see his horns now.
Yep.
So that motherfucker ain't coming here to bring change. Them dumbass didn't realize he did bring change.
Change, yeah. You got chains. Chains. What's up? What was that sound of the men working on the chain gang?
The chain.
Oh, he even had a group, the chain gang.
Chain, yep.
The Chung gang or something. Sound like chains. Mm-hmm. The Chung, was it the Chung gang? I can't remember. They just did a damn Houdini.
He materialized.
Ain't the Hebrew word for
lightning
there.
Is Barak. Yeah, but that book was not. It was written in Greek, not Hebrew. But it can be Barak, yeah. I know what you're saying. That's just all twisting scriptures around and stuff, man. It sounds good. But actually, the word Barak in Hebrew means to bless. Really means to bless. Like Barak Atha, that means bless you. If I say Barak Atha Akia, that means bless you, my brother. It wouldn't really be Barak, it'd be Barak Fa. Because it has a Q on it, not a K. But his name doesn't have a Q, it's a K. There's a hard sound, Barak. That means bless. So really, Barak means to bless, actually. The way he spells it. I could say Barak Atha.
His real name is Barry.
Barry Sortero.
That's
not
Obama's real name?
Yeah, that's what they say, Barry. That's Big Barry right there.
Big Barry.
Well, that's it. That's your boy. You ever watch Pastor Manny? He was talking shit about Obama. He been talking shit about Obama before he even got elected. That's the only thing he ever got right in this whole motherfucking ministry. You never watched Pastor Manny?
Oh yeah. You watch him?
It's entertainment.
Oh, he's some funny motherfucking. He be talking that jive talk. Call Obama the long leg of Mac Daddy.
Yeah, that was some clever shit by Esau putting Barack in there, man. They knew what they were doing when that motherfucker was conceived, man. They knew what they were doing.
Oh yeah, he was groomed for that position.
Yeah, everybody praised him though, like he was a god.
Yeah, that's how he was groomed.
You don't think he ain't connected to the ratchet that been going on around?
Yeah, he's connected.
But that was
in
place.
In the sense of him,
he's just somebody the scriptures too.
He's not the one.
Did you see that? Did you see that channel I sent you?
Yeah, Ronald Reagan.
Kajani America.
Ronald Reagan came out with the Year of the Bible.
Huh?
Ronald Reagan established in 1983 or 84. 85 was the year of the Bible.
Yep, sure.
He ran scripture. Yeah. I mean, actually, I'm going to break it down like this. In the ancient Roman Empire, all the Caesars pretty much were gods. They built statues of them, and they was the head of the Roman religion.
Damn!
Like, after a Caesar died, you know, they was...
Damn!
After a Caesar died, they was deified. You know what that means? Look it up. After every Caesar died, they were deified, meaning they were... said they were a god. So they pretty much do the same thing with every last president. It was deified. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I think he's the last president, though.
I mean, he could be.
I hope to say. Even if he did get to that point of election, he got the power to suspend it anyway. All the shit going on.
Because if the Ebola virus break out.
Why you call it Ebola?
That's what everybody been calling it that from Obama.
Oh, okay.
But if the Ebola break out, they going to suspend every goddamn thing. They suspended the government over there in Liberia. No more elections. It's just lockdown, martial law.
They call it Sharia. It's a Sharia law.
That's Sharia. That's the Muslim shit.
Oh, okay. Well, I thought that was all over that area.
I don't fucking know.
There's so much chaos going on. There's Sharia law rising over there. They're everywhere.
I don't know what Liberia is. I don't know if they're Muslim or Christian. They're probably Christian, I bet. Or Voodoo.
It's probably a combination.
Probably Voodoo.
All the wars and starters going on. Because
you know Liberia was created by America under Lincoln. Wasn't Lincoln? I don't fucking know. But that's where a bunch of slaves... Former slaves went back to Africa.
Yeah, they revolted. They revolted. It actually was, I think it was the only successful revolt, slave revolt.
But they call it repatriation. So called. But motherfuckers ain't even from Africa to begin with. Say how stupid they was.
So you think they're gonna just have that Ebola shit start just so Obama can stay in office?
Well, I mean it could be they could do a billion different things with that, man. The possibilities are endless. They could use that for the microchip. Yeah, they could use that for martial law, for the camps, they could use that for vaccinations. The possibilities.
Not 2015, 2016.
Yeah, 16.
I don't see us going nowhere near that. I don't even see us going past that. I don't see us making it to spring, to be honest with you. I'm just saying, I'd be surprised we hear in spring.
Yeah, I mean.
I'd be surprised we hear.
Because the next election come around, who would be president? Rand Paul? That's like the most popular motherfucker.
Ron Paul?
Ron Paul?
He's speaking truth, though.
Yeah, Ron Paul.
I'm talking about his son, though.
Hillary might drop that before.
Oh, Romney?
Fuck that one.
Because the motherfuckers are so mad at Obama and shit now.
They found out everything Romney was saying was true.
Yeah, because Romney was warning them about Russia. He kept telling y'all better pay attention to Russia. They was like, nah. But Ron, he's a big weirdo. He's a goddamn Mormon.
Weird.
He's too goddamn happy.
What's wrong with being happy?
Hey, he's
Edomite. Oh, you want to know
what
Edomite? That's an Edomite.
Yeah, he's all. Man, he lies, dude. He lied about everything. He caught his ass in so many lies. They got videos on YouTube of Romney flip flopping. You can watch it. It was like a 15-minute video, just flip flop after flip flop.